and action.
What's up, y'all? It's gonna be Brooks, your senior officer.
What's good, y'all? It's me, Henry, your CRE News / the Phoenix Network show director.
And welcome to the first episode of the CRE News.
So as your newly director of the Phoenix Network show, I want to appreciate everybody, every single one of you who is watching this broadcast live at this current moment. Also, I cannot thank enough the people who volunteered to be in this episode. And as well, I want to thank our club members who put in a lot of hard work, a lot of dedication over the span of these 5 months that was working with this broadcast. And now we're here in our big grand debut episode. So let the episode begin and we'll enjoy.
Well, thank you for having me today. So as we gear up for this season, our number one goal this year, right, is to win the region championship. No sport in school history has won the region championship. We made it to the region championship game last year and lost. So that's our number one team goal, is to win the region championship, make it back to the state playoffs. And then other goals, just is get better every single game, take it one game at a time. And then hopefully I can start building a pipeline and start getting these kids to play college basketball. So those are the goals that I have going into this 2023-2024 basketball season. And it should be a good one.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, everyone. We're here with CRA News. My name is William.
My name is Nixon Reyes.
And we're here today with
Suwaka, as a varsity basketball player. How is your experience in leadership? Apply on and off the court?
Playing varsity basketball, I'm kind of better with teamwork and communication skills. Say if I'm at a job or if I'm working in groups at school, I'm really confident with my teammates and my colleagues. And I got that through playing basketball too. And whenever there's like an issue, we're good at like tackling it, you know, finding ways to get through it.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Good morning. I'm here in Corporate Work City. What's your name?
Mr. Johnson.
Okay, Mr. Johnson, can you please share a memorable experience you've had with the students here?
Yeah, so I actually have good experiences almost every day. I like when students have an issue and then I can help them resolve it. Or if something's going on at work, we can help them resolve it. And one of my favorite things to do is go down into the cafeteria at lunchtime. That's when I get an opportunity to see all the students, so I like doing that.
That sounds interesting. Thank you. And does Corporate Work City have any fun things planned for this year for the students?
I think we do. So last year we had the competition amongst the different grade levels, right? You guys won the second. I think the first contest, I think the juniors won, then you guys won second as freshmen. And then this year we're going to do the same thing. This semester we'll have competition amongst the classes. So I think that'll be fun. Something to look forward to.
Okay, thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Teach me to see.
Enthusiasts.
I'm Melanie.
And I'm Josh Kerr.
And we're back, and it's time to relive the unforgettable sports moments that define 2023. 2023 kicked off with the Olympic Games, where athletics pushed the boundaries of human potential. Moments of glory, heartache, and sheer determination echoed in every event.
Nikolai Dredjic, the undeniable best in the world right now, despite past playoff doubts, last year he led Denver's unstoppable run through the NBA, a seven-footer dominating every level, scoring efficiently and averaging a triple-double. Dredjic is simply unstoppable.
Meet Jude Bellingham, a 20-year-old sensation linked to football legends. With 10 goals and 10 appearances for Real Madrid, his impact on the pitch speaks volumes.
Novak Djokovic, better known as the Joker, holds strong as the world's number two single players in 2023. His epic comeback against Carlos Alcaraz and securing his third Cincinnati title affirm his dominance in tennis.
Wow, what a year it's been for sports fans.
From record-breaking performances and nail-biting finishes, 2023 delivered unforgettable moments.
Stay tuned with CRA News sports segments for more thrilling actions in the world of sports. Oh my god.
Welcome back to another banger, guys.
Today we're doing a trivia segment with Gia.
This is a trivia segment with Gia.
Me too. Alright, so first question is up. We're gonna do some like.
No, you gotta say your
competitors. Okay, so our computers are.
Say your name.
Ray.
Ray.
Renata.
Raphael. Wow, you got all started with an R.
Today we're here with.
Ethan.
So our first question is some light, like, who is SpongeBob's best friend?
Patrick. Okay, yeah. One point for you.
What vitamin does the sun's UV ray help?
Oh.
Which animal has the largest eyes? Wait,
what? Orcas.
What's
an
orca?
Orca. A whale.
Guess? Which animal has the largest eyes? Let's see if they get this. Who's on the $10 bill?
Benjamin Franklin.
We're all thinking about the $100 bill.
No, that's the $100 bill. What's the $10
bill? Abe Lincoln.
No. No, it starts with an A.
Andrew
Taylor.
Oh,
no.
Andrew
Jackson. No. It's not an Andrew.
I know it.
Tony
Walker.
What vitamin does the sun's
UV
ray help?
Vitamin D. Ooh, he's smart.
In what country did Halloween originate?
India.
In what state did the first baseball game take place?
You should know this.
In what state did the first?
Think up north.
Like up, here.
You're close.
Yeah.
Okay.
Michael Jordan starred in what movie?
Space
Jam.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, he said that top.
I don't know.
So, okay, what is the official language of Egypt? Okay, yeah.
Alright, so who's this?
Zidane.
Okay, good. Okay.
Who's on the $10 bill?
Benjamin
Franklin.
No.
It starts with an A.
A?
No.
HG is the chemical symbol for which element?
Hydrogen.
Hey, cheater!
What is the official language of Egypt?
Can you say that again?
Who is on the $10 bill?
No, wait.
Johnny Kennedy.
What's his name? Oh, I forgot his name.
Starts with an A.
Wait, what?
Oh,
wait,
this is
not for me.
Wait, nobody know that. Alexander Hamilton.
Who that?
Starts with an A.
Arabic?
Yeah.
Who was the first Kardashian slash Jenner to become a billionaire?
Kim Kardashian. Mm-mm.
I don't know. Yeah. Oh, these are some. Okay. We can just sign. Who's this? Y'all better move.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, what is this? Okay, good. Okay, I think she won. Yeah. Okay, yeah, our winner!
You gotta be famous.
Yeah. I think you won. So this is our winner.
What can I say? What can I say?
Who is this?
Zendaya.
I see Zendaya.
You have our winner.
Let's go.
Okay. What is this?
Chanel.
Okay, you got it.
Okay.
What?
No, do that one. Oh.
Who is this?
Zendaya.
All right. Who's the winner? Oh. What?
The winner is all three of them.
Hi, I'm Yohani Fernandez, and I'm here with Mr. Engelhardt, who was chosen as one of Chris Harry's favorite teachers. So, Mr. Engelhardt, can you tell us a little more about yourself?
Sure. So, my name is Mr. Engelhardt. I'm a Jesuit regent, which means I'm in formation for the priesthood. This is my 7th year of formation overall, and my 2nd year here at Christ Our Rey.
So, can you tell us a little bit more about what you love here at Christ Our Rey, its culture, students, teachers?
My favorite thing about Christ Our Rey is definitely the students here. Since the first day I got here, I love getting to know all the students in my house, in my math classes here on the 5th floor, and getting to know them inside and outside the classroom has been a real blessing. Just to get to see how many different personalities and interests and things they bring to the school to fill it with so much joy in life and to help me to learn more about them and the world they live in and what their hopes are for their futures.
Can you tell us a little more about your art club?
Sure, so I'm the moderator for Art Club this year. It's a time and a space and opportunity for our students to get out some of their creative talents, to practice drawing or sketching, painting, a time to explore different types of art. And hopefully we're gonna give our kids the opportunity as well to do things like try their hand at pottery or do things like field trips to museums so they can learn to appreciate art in a variety of forms.
That sounds amazing. Thank you, Mr. Engelhardt.
Thank you.
The ring ceremony coming up, what is the importance of the ring to you?
Since the ring is always on your finger and you're always wearing it usually, I feel like it signifies where you came from, the school that you were at. It says the class of 2024 on it, and it also says Christ Our Rey Atlanta Jesuit High School. So I feel like you're always going to know that you're from Christ Our Rey. It's always going to be a part of you, you know, when you graduate, you know, since we're seniors and we get it, you're always going to be like, yeah, I'm from Christ Our Rey. And everyone else who comes across you in life is going to be able to see that ring. Like, wow, this guy's from Christ Our Rey, you know? So I feel like it signifies you and the school.
Yeah, for sure. You know, I get what he said. Everything he said, yeah, it's very important thing for seniors. Yeah, for sure.
Are y'all excited about getting the ring?
Super excited.
Yeah, super. Like, I don't think I've ever been more excited for anything. Like, for anything else, you know.
Yeah,
this is like the moment.
Yeah, this is crazy.
This is what I've been waiting for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
Congratulations, you have been accepted to the...
It's like I got everything I could ever want and need. I'm just speechless. Like, all my life I've been hoping to become like one hell of an engineer, and now here I am as a yellow jacket.
I travel all around the world and meet with our alums, and they are phenomenal. And there's no question that you all are gonna follow in those footsteps.
It is no easy thing. So taking this moment, it means a lot to us and for you as well.
Georgia Tech is not just a university where you go to learn and then pass your exams. It's a community where we all just collaborate in research to make the world a better place through the power of STEM and humanities.
This is certainly the highlight of my week, probably my month. I had a chance to meet 7 amazing students that I'm hoping are gonna come to Georgia Tech and make us even better.
Krista Ray Flames, I hope you enjoyed this edition of the Phoenix News. And I am wishing all of you best of luck in the second semester, and that the end of the school year will be sooner than you think. So finish strong, and congratulations to the class of 2024, because it is 2024. So this is your big, big year. We will miss you. We wish you well. And we hope that all of you get all of the college acceptances that you're looking for. Viva Krista Ray.
So you've reached the end of the episode, so we want to appreciate you for sticking all the way out into the end. Expect more episodes to be premiering later in the future. And well, follow us at Phoenix Network Official on Instagram. So I feel like you can do that right now. So at Phoenix Network Official on Instagram, and we will be promoting a lot of content. We will be putting a lot of exclusives and a lot. So you can just definitely follow us at Phoenix Network Official on Instagram. So thank you very much for watching this episode. This was our big grand debut episode. So I feel like we can sign off now. So this is me, your host of the Phoenix Network Show, signing off.
All right, cut the lights out. We're done.
Super.